gonna like it?
He will love it. Are you kidding me? I'm so happy to see you.
According to the news, I'm lucky I get to see you at all. Oh, that's why I couldn't get through.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I'm getting a little more attention than even I can stand.
Well, Jason said you're okay, but I mean, I ask him how anyone is, and that's what he says. Are you?
Do I look intact?
That much I got from the papers. Where's the hero?
Yeah, Jack is upstairs on the computer. Jason's my hero, too, though. You can tell him I said that.
I will. He doesn't even know I'm here yet.
Wait, so you came to see me before him? There's nothing wrong, right?
With me?
Well, I know you're on your new medication, and...
Well, I mean, I felt a little weird the first week, but either I got used to it or it just went away.
Oh, I don't know how you knew to come here, but I'm really glad you did.
So, you were trapped in there with Sonny for how long?
What did Sonny say?
I haven't talked to him yet.
Yeah, I haven't talked to him either. We really didn't think anyone was going to find us.
You must have been really scared.
Yeah, I was really scared. But you know what I realized? When you think you're going to die, you don't necessarily think as much about what's going to happen as you do about what never did.
I know.
We said a lot of things to each other.
I can imagine.
We made love. You are the only person who knows this. Unless Sonny told someone, I don't know if maybe he's...
No, he wouldn't do that. But he is going to be waiting for you to tell him what it meant.
I wish someone would tell me what it meant.
Brenda, status file on...
Hey!
Hey, well, you aren't just what the doctor ordered.
How long are you in town for?
Just for the day. I'm glad to see you're in one piece, too.
Well, I mean, what's a few rocks on the noggin to an Australian? But I'm not so thick, I don't know when to make myself scarce. You're going to be around for a while, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's someone I need to go and see. Clear up a few things in person.
It's busy.
Give him 5 minutes.
What's he supposed to ask Brenda if he gets her?
How she is.
Well, I could have done that.
Well, he'll know she's lying.
Huh? How?
I don't know. Ask him.
I got $42 in my pocket. Am I lying?
Then you don't need that 20 you're trying to hit me up for.
Look. Everybody lies when you ask them if they're okay. It's only polite.
Yeah. 5 minutes.
Well, if it isn't the boy wonder.
You look like a homing pigeon. You know that?
Well, I just homed in here to congratulate you on not being crushed like an ant.
Well, I hope you're here to tell me you found out who Harry Silver was working with.
Funny thing, since you've been otherwise occupied, all the smack in the city's dried out. Why is that?
Maybe Harry's partner is stuck. Maybe he doesn't know the local turf. That's what he needed a partner for.
Or maybe what went down between you two was a bad business arrangement.
You're amazing, you know that? This guy, whoever he is, could be sitting right under your nose with 100 kilos of heroin he can't move. But what's he gonna sweat about? You only have eyes for me.
Nobody.
Wow. You guys sure are jumpy tonight.
Enough people try to kill you, that happens.
Right. You're a victim of unseen forces. That's your story, right?
You ever thought of investigating my role in the Watergate break-in? Did anybody actually see me at First Communion practice that day? How about the Son of Sam killings? Why do you think they call me Sonny? Oh, look! Somebody's jaywalking. I paid him to do that.
That's cute.
How'd you make detective? Were you the only one who could find the coffee filters?
Oh, how'd you get your career started, Sonny, huh? Were you pimping for the cheerleader squad?
Oh, I can see you now with the guidance counselor. Yes, Mr. Taggert, with your IQ, you could either go to police work, or you can go to an institution where they teach you how to tie your shoes.
There is no law that says I have to take this from scum like you.
Then prove me I'm wrong, detective. Because since you came on the case, Marilyn Cooper is dead, Harry Silver is dead.
Nobody.
And Brenda and I weren't far from it. But hey, you know what? Somebody might make the mistake one day and think that maybe you're not that stupid, and you will be the next casualty.
Is that a threat?
Unbelievable.
What am I gonna do, wake up with a bullet in my head like Deke?
Deke? Ooh. Who's Deke? What's he to you?
I know. I know that you're going to tell me that I just need to tell Jax everything. And you're right.
No, I don't have any advice.
Well, that's my advice to myself. I mean, that's what Jax would do, you know? I mean, look at the way he is.
Oh, God.
He wants to talk to Miranda about something, so he just calls her right in front of us. And he's just going to go talk to her right to her face. And you want to know what the best part is? The best part of all is that if I wanted to know what he was going to talk to her about, he would just tell me. I don't even want to know, though. I don't even want to know anything else about that relationship. The best thing about this whole situation is I really kind of feel like maybe Miranda's irrelevant now.
Well, look, maybe Jax will understand. You know, the circumstances you were under.
I told Sonny that I loved him. There's really no way for Jax to understand that, is there?
No, I just know the way Sonny thinks. If you said that to him, if you made love to him, he thinks your marriage is over.
That's exactly what he'd say.
But it's not up to him. Or is he right?
Hydrocodone. Mm-hmm. Take one every 4 to 6 hours.
Didn't you were hurt?
No, I've been taking those since, remember, the hit and run last year.
Oh.
And, these I got after all this happened. They took us to the hospital and they gave me these just in case, which is perfect because that's exactly how I've been taking them for the last year, just in case. I mean, I started out taking them for pain and then I started taking them just in case I was going to have pain or just in case I thought I was going to have a bad day or just in case I couldn't sleep, just in case I was feeling insecure. So I don't take them, you know, one every 4 to 6 hours anymore. In fact, I can't even remember the last time I even counted how many I take in one day.
What is hydrocodone?
And basically, it's just a good excuse to not have to make any decisions. Like whether or not my marriage is over. When I was in the cave, I went through heavy withdrawals from them. I was sitting there in the cave, and remember, I was thinking if I could make one phone call right now, I would just call to get more pills. After they saved us and they took us to the hospital, I was going to ask for some as soon as I got there, but then I found out that I could be pregnant. I'm not. But now, all I can think about is that I just want to take more. You know, I want a pill more than sleep or food or love or anything. In fact, I couldn't wait today for Jax to go upstairs so I could take another one.
Did you?
No, I didn't. I don't even know how I didn't or why I didn't. Maybe I do know why. I know that I have to tell Jax what happened between me and Sonny. I just want to
I just want to feel whatever I have to feel when I tell him. I just want... I just want my head to be really clear when it happens. So if there's a decision that I have to make, it'll be the right one.
I heard it from you. Or did you forget?
The name Deke? Not for me.
Yeah, you were hollering it when they hauled you out of the ground, half out of your head. You heard it, didn't you?
I wasn't really listening.
Yeah, well, I was. See, and contrary to what you believe, I do my homework.
Then why don't you go home and do it? I got all sorts of dead neighbors in Brooklyn just crying out to be investigated, too.
I'll be in touch.
With reality for a change? How the hell does he know Deke?
I don't know. But not the way he said.
He could have heard Deke's name.
No, Jason would have known.
But what does Taggert know?
He was supposed to be getting a background on Taggert.
Well, I did. Who is Deke?
My stepfather, cop.
I didn't know his name. Well, like I told you before, Taggert went through the police academy in Brooklyn.
So, is the question, did they know each other?
No, the question is, why the hell did I have to know either of them? Keep looking, and can you make the call for me?
Clear out before I'm thrown out, too. Deke, that's the one thing you can never forgive me for, isn't it?
That's the great thing about memory lane. Just keeps going around in circles.
Good night, Michael.
Still busy. Or off the hook.
She must be making a time of it. Who was that in the hall before? Coming out of Catherine.
What, that guy who sued Monica?
What's his name?
Dorman.
You don't like him?
He looks at me the way the Quartermains used to. He's conceited, pushy. Every word out of his mouth is an insult or a lie.
He's really raking her over the coals. That bothers you?
It's pretty disgusting when somebody's nice enough to have sex with you, to go on TV and complain about it.
True.
Plus, I don't get why anybody believes him. He's fake.
Well, some people don't pick up on those things. But I don't have to tell you, you'd be doing Monica a favor if you could prove he was lying.
Why would I?
Well, some people just get to you. I mean, you don't have to know why. I'm not just saying because the woman raised you.
But it's over, right? It's all settled.
You know how you feel when Taggert talks to you like you're dirt, like you're nothing?
Yeah.
I can pretty much imagine that's the way Monica feels, except a judge went ahead and declared she was dirt. If you want to call that settled, okay. Excuse me. Granted, she got herself in the situation. And sometimes those are the hardest to get out of. Busy. Do me a favor. If I start talking like Mike, tell me to shut up. You don't have to do anything. You don't owe them anything. Thank you.
How'd you feel about seeing Kevin Collins? It wouldn't even be therapy, really, because he's not even licensed to practice anymore. But he has had experience with drug counseling. I remember he told Stone and I that when we were first getting to know him. And he is wise, he is non-judgmental, and he's discreet. And he never condescends to you because he knows what it's like to hit bottom himself.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know what he could tell me that I haven't already told myself.
He might surprise you. In fact, I would bet on that.
That would have broken my heart.
Well, my nose and I weren't quite as heroic as the papers would have you think.
Still, I didn't heal something in you, didn't it? Thought it might have. Now I knew I was right. Being able to do for Brenda what you couldn't do for me back then.
Yeah, I think it did.
Good. Then, whatever you and I are to each other from now on, let's keep the guilt out of it.
Deal.
Of course, you didn't have to go so far as to save Sonny Corinthos' worthless neck.
Well, I'm sure things are clear on his side now, too.
Oh, well, forgive me if I'm a bit skeptical.
Well, it's got to be obvious even to him. I mean, that he's the worst thing that could ever happen to Brenda.
You think that bothers him?